reason we came aboard was to find a way to stop you from landing on top of our colony on Atlas.
Yeah.
No, Captain Kirk. I will certainly not set the Compassion down in a populated area. Now that I can see it is there.
Good.
I am at present in communication with the planetary authorities.
Really?
And they are directing me to a stationary orbit until further arrangements can be made for my wards. Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still set to land on Atabus Colony?
No, Captain Kirk. Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still set to land on Atabus Colony?
Seems a little too easy, doesn't it?
How did your systems become damaged?
I am sorry, I cannot explain this at this time. I do not even know if it is explicable. But I will search my memory for an answer for you. Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still... Please clarify the anomalies we have perceived while being on board.
I am sorry, I cannot explain this. Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still... Please clarify...
I'm curious about what your builders really had in mind, shipping off all these people off-planet.
I have no information about your eugenics wars. But a fundamental social philosophy of the builders was that civilized people of goodwill would tolerate and value variability as a sign of cultural and social health. That a civilization will be judged by its tolerance of disparate ideas, by how it treats those who cannot protect themselves, be they very young, very old, or otherwise challenged, by the measure of altruism extended to those less powerful, even when rightfully in possession of something desired.
A central aspect of Vulcan philosophy is embodied in the Idic. Infinite diversity in infinite combinations. It would seem the builders pursued similar high ideals.
High ideals, perhaps, but that does not explain why these people are in space phase.
More than this, I cannot explain. However, you can locate additional library data under the heading Compassion. Oh, I haven't made it available. I should have done that immediately. I can't imagine why I didn't think of it.
Fascinating, Captain. That instance of forgetfulness makes it possible to speculate that the phase is not wholly restored after all.
Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still set to land on Atabus Colony?
Well, we didn't do anything to restore it. We're just down here now.
Please clarify the anomalies we have perceived while...
I'd still like to know a little more about why these people were shipped into space.
I have no information about your eugenics war.
A central aspect of Vulcan philosophy is in...
High ideals, perhaps, but that...
More than this, I cannot... Then are there other questions?
Is the ship still... Please...
I'd still like to...
I'd be interested to learn more... That's all for now, FaZe. I assume... I'd be interested to learn more about those who built this ship.
My best recommendation is to examine the library records under Builders or Technology. There is more data than I can easily explain. Then are there other questions?
Now, just 1 minute, FaZe. Are you listening? You keep saying you can't remember or you lack data or what have you. Even the library data seems vague, incomplete, and contradictory. If you don't know, then who does?
Well, we haven't looked
Forgive
at the
pause.
Data.
I had to think long and hard to discover if you had correctly passed this final test.
If we had what?
You correctly identify the heart of the matter. Let me introduce you to my builders.
The Brassica.
This is madness! Faez, what is this?
Despite our misgivings, you have shown yourselves to be the representatives of spacefaring peoples we, the Brassica, would most trust to make first contact with.
Huh.
The contest has been in progress for some time. Situations in which your true colors have been explored. The invitation has been made. You may return to your ship if you prefer. Or you may step through whenever you are ready. Then, the final round begins.
I think you have it right, Captain Klar. Huh. This is madness, Jim.
I think, Bones, it's Shakespeare who had it right. Though this be madness, yet there is a method in it.
I agree with the sentiment, Captain Kirk. There is something more going on here.
Undoubtedly.
Far deeper than first appearances have suggested. I imagine you will accept the invitation. I will certainly choose to go, whether you do or not.
Well, how?
I believe the invitation is extended to...
I will not permit that, Captain Klar. I will take all methods to prevent you. I will not go. It is certainly a Federation trick.
You begin to sound like Tuscan in the other room. Get a grip of yourself and act like an officer.
Oh boy. Let's save. Actually, what do we have there? Let's save before I mess with anything.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
What is this?
A sealed tube with connectors at either end, which can provide illumination when inserted into an appropriately powered socket.
Did the phase give that to us? What's this?
A long twist of insulated wire.
When the hell did we pick this crap up? Maybe it did just give it to us.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Other than how it got into our inventory.
Nothing unusual.
I have a strange feeling about this room. We might find... Is the ship still set to land on...
Please? I'd still like to know...
I'd be interested to learn... That's all for now, FaZe.
Now wait 1 minute, cock! I make my request politely and I am ignored. That cannot go unnoticed.
I demand
the right to be heard.
Please, ask freely. I will answer as best I can.
FaZe, this ship passed through the heart of Klingon space. We were not even aware of it until it was nearly out of our territory. We backtracked it and found it must have closely approached places we find sensitive. We expect assurances that data you may have collected there will not reach the hands of those who mean us harm.
We seek proof. We expect you to download your entire memory into our ship's computers, that we may search it for data you have no right to.
Thereby would you not acquire data to which you have no right?
Asking for too much.
Strongly. While it is true we are interested in the knowledge and technology you possess, technology to pass through our empire undetected, knowledge of how to twist space back upon itself, for that data, we will treat with you as one civilized people with another. But it is a justified request that we ask you to destroy all data dealing with anything you learn within our borders.
Had I any data, I would agree to seal it. However, as you should have deduced, I have none. Until my sensory systems were repaired, my ability to receive and process data was severely impaired. Especially in regard to external data updates.
I hate that voice.
Based on my present reanalysis of nearby space, I would speculate that my only data on your present sphere of influence would be as that area of space existed a very long time ago indeed.
That is information for us to know, not you. Erase it.
Silence! Haze, we would welcome access to that information.
Guys are funny.
On the same basis as we would bargain with you for technological data, we have more to offer with you, I believe, than the Federation represented by these others.
Klingon kom palha nesoe hatkla. So web korda.
What's he saying?
FaZe, do not be hasty making that decision.
I lack sufficient data to make any assessment. I can give no answer at this time. I will do my best, Captain. Although intelligent entities often find that there are more questions than answers.
Okay.
Captain, this is a unique opportunity. I believe we must take this opportunity. I also believe that Captain Klar's presence will prove an asset. I am less than sanguine about Klar's aid accompanying us, however.
Yeah. Same to you, Vulcan. What are you going to do about it? Pinch me in the neck?
Don't tempt him.
The lure of the unknown, Captain, that's what makes life worth living.
Mm-hmm.
It's why I joined Starfleet. A chance to communicate with other people, other places, strange new worlds. I don't believe we can turn our backs on this opportunity.
And Bones? Behind this thing?
I'm a little dubious, Jim, but that's what we're out here for in the first place. I say let's go for it. I even think this may be an interesting experiment in diplomacy to have the Klingon present on such an expedition. Although I must say, I'm not exactly overjoyed to spend any more time with the Captain Sour Mug Aid there.
You're one to talk, you quack. Maybe you'll hit me with your hypo and throw me out of the airlock, eh? That's what I'd expect of your sort.
I don't see an airlock in here.
This room appears strangely comp... This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
Can't we...
An iridescent crystalline lens about the size of your palm. Although the lens magnifies things you look at through it, somewhat like a magnifying lens, the image is distorted and warped. Pretty soon, this seems like a non-productive way to use the paralens.
The bubble seems to be part force field and part physical obstruction. Not quite like anything I've seen outside this room. If there is anything within, and I get no such reading, it is inaccessible.
Just in case.
I'm just a simple country doctor, not a magician. There are some things I just can't fix.
Although the lens magnifies...
Save new game. Replace...
Let's start messing with stuff.
There is nothing particularly interesting in an opaque bubble. It doesn't even reflect your image.
No, I don't think that's necessary. It's probably sturdier than it looks.
I'm sorry, Captain, but this seems pretty uninteresting to me. Captain, this looks more like Mr. Spock's area of expertise. Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this.
Coy.
Don't know what to make of it myself. Seems pretty uninteresting.
He walked over there, though.
I don't do windows, Jim. I don't understand any of this, Jim.
Captain Klar, I will not let you depart.
What did he... I don't know what I did there. Spock.
This bubble exhibits no interesting features, Captain. I do not believe I can directly interface with that, Captain. This is not a life form, Captain, but it does register with biomagnetics and considerable electrical complexity. This is the heart of a functioning, artificially intelligent construct.
Oh! He punched him. Is this the aide?
A Klingon officer who's...
Okay.
This appears to be a shimmering portal to someplace else.
Captain, I'm getting a thoroughly anomalous reading.
Are you suggesting it might be...
The doors on this ship have given previous evidence of...
They certainly aren't as capable in the field of...
Captain, if I may interject...
I was thinking the same thing myself.
And I also, Captain Kirk.
It's all the same stuff here. Okay.
Captain, this appears to be an intact paralens, a nearly unique form of computer data recording media, quite advanced. The glass shards I noticed in the oratory are probably the broken remnants of others like this, but we should be able to read this.
I don't remember glass shards in the oratory.
Pretty thing. It's like a sun catcher my aunt used to hang in her window.
Nah.
This palm-sized lens glitters like iridescent crystal.
Uhura, doesn't this remind you of...
Yes, Captain. This appears to be an intact paralens.
Same thing. Okay, Spock.
This crystal construct has an unusual light-scattering property.
We can't do anything with it? Can we take it?
The crystalline lens feels cool and surprisingly heavy, with smoothly polished edges.
Okay.
This seems pointless.
To look at it? First time that happened, looking at something in an inventory.
Nothing unusual.
Yeah, nothing unusual.
Do you really expect me to analyze this gem?
Sure, why not? What is this? Can we put it in here?
An unusual computer terminal device.
Yeah, let's put it in there. Now, what can we do with this stuff, though?
This seems like a nearly workable idea, but the light bar is presenting some problems.
Huh. It is, huh? Alright, let's see if we can put this in here.
That doesn't seem appropriate at this time.
What? Why isn't it appropriate?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
This doesn't seem to have any application here.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
No application?
This doesn't seem to have any application here.
Alright, move aside so we can get to this.
This doesn't seem to attach here.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Here?
The information I acquired from Puzzlewit's mind indicates this could be a delicate operation. Easily mishandled. I think we should start off with the connector from the light bar in order to complete these repairs, Captain.
Okay. We'll do that.
If you'll bring that over to me, I might have a better suggestion if I took a closer look at it.
Oh?
I worked with things like these when I was younger. Given our surroundings, see if you don't find this more useful.
Yeah, he's pretty smart, this guy. Oh. Where is it? Oh, he took those off.
A constructed mechanism permitting an electrical power supply to be safely joined to an appliance or device.
Very interesting.
Nothing unusual.
Alright.
Save new game. Replace previous. Save new game. New game.
Let's replace. Caution to the winds and all that stuff. So, let's put this in there.
Allow me, Captain. Let me do that. The information I acquired from Puzzlewit's mind indicates this could be a delicate operation. Easily mishandled. I think you will find it fits just here.
Okay.
Lieutenant Uhura, if you will bring over that length of wire while I hold this in place, I believe we can get this repaired speedily.
Certainly, Mr. Spock. With that in place, I can see that it will easily fit. Here.
She's gonna do it automatically. Excellent.
The final connection is made, and Uhura smiles widely.
That's it! That fixes the broken connection.
Yay! Now what?
Thank you! I am now once again whole! And no longer an intelligence divided against myself. The system you repaired will re-enable me to analyze and update received data from external and internal sensor systems.
Hope this is okay.
Altering conceptual constructs of previously acquired data. These systems appear to have been malfunctioning for some time, although it will take additional review to clarify all conditions. Much may have been lost permanently.
Jim, do you notice? The
phase isn't switching between I and we like it did in the oratory. And the voice is a single note, not a harmonic chord of blended voices.
And it hasn't suggested we go get something to eat either.
I am chagrined that my disabilities have endangered my mission. The compassion was launched with the best of intentions. If I can answer anyone's questions, I will endeavor to do so.
Captain Kirk, you don't mind if I ask a question, do you?
You'll get your turn, Klingon. Just hold your horses. Other things come first.
I still don't like the voice.
Be my guest, Captain. Ask away. You'll get your... Be my guest, Captain. Ask away.
That you give me first place to speak is a mark of honor, Captain Kirk. And does not pass unnoticed. Particularly in light of the urgency of your own questions. Pays. This ship passed through the heart of Klingon space. We were not even aware of it until it...
We seek proof. We expect you to download your entire memory into our ship's computers.
Hey.
We may search it for data you have no right
to. The aid was beamed away.
Would you not acquire data to which you have no right?
My aid speaks too strongly.
That's so messed up.
Had I any data, I would agree to seal it.
That is information for us to know, not you. Erase it.
Silence. Phase. We...
Klingon Kong Parhat.
Phase, do not be hasty making that decision.
I lack sufficient data to make...
Is the ship still set to land on Atabus Colony?
No, Captain Kirk. I will certainly not set the Compassion down in a populated area. Now that I can... Then are there other questions?
Now just 1 minute, Phase. Are you listening? You keep saying you can't remember or you lack data or what have you.
Forgive the pause.
It's all the same.
I had to think long and hard.
This is
madness.
Despite
messed
our
up.
Misgivings, you have shown yourselves to be...
I think you have it right, Captain.
I think, Bones, it's Shakespeare who had it.
I agree with the sentiment, Captain Kirk.
I will not permit that, Captain Klar.
You begin to sound like Tuscan in the other room.
What about the... This?
That doesn't seem appropriate.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's...
Well, the information's on there, right?
This doesn't seem to have any application here.
Do I have anything left? No.
Nothing unusual.
Well, I don't know how to read this thing.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
What's the terminal for, then?
I have no intention of letting my captain leave in your company through that hellish door. There's nothing you can say to change my mind, either.
I'm not bringing him. He's coming if he wants to.
I am determined to go explore. There may be dangers, but I accepted that challenge the first day I decided to make my life in space.
You get no response. The lure of the unknown, Captain.
All right.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Gonna save again before we go through here. And I'm gonna go through here. Wish you could use that data crystal.
Mr. Scott, they've disappeared off the sensors.
What do you mean, laddie?
They've just vanished.
Vanished? Yet there is a method in it. Probably the final episode.
Captain's log, stardate 6269.3. The landing party and the Klingon Captain Klar have passed through a portal in time and space. We're about to face tests by the Brassica. Success will mean formal relations. Failure will mean unknown.
Welcome. We applaud your willingness to confront the unknown.
That's the thing.
Please tell us what's going on. Where are we?
Patience. I cannot answer all yet. Those elements of our society still ill at ease with your cultures have more questions.
We've had enough. No more foolish tests.
Just gonna look at the choices.
More tests. Let's just get on with it. I'd like to hear what the others think. We've had enough. No more foolish tests.
Okay, guys. Stay tuned for what is probably going to be the final episode and my round of episodes of this game. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and live long and prosper.